Hello students, welcome again to this class of operations management. So in last class we have studied about forecasting. We have seen what forecasting is, right? And we have also seen the difference between the prediction and forecasting. Okay, we have seen basically what is objective forecasting and what is subjective forecasting, right? And we have seen predict the future and cannot exactly we can only predict the future and cannot exactly see it, right? It might not always be right. Okay, so now before going to objective techniques, right, that involves somewhat of mathematical equations and all that, first of all we will have a flavor of what are subjective techniques to predict the future. Okay, so in last class I have told you that there are a few judgmental techniques that are used, right, to forecast the future, where we have a team of experts, right? So one of such technique is Delphi method. Okay, so what is Delphi method? So basically it is a subjective judgmental technique, right? This is the method that I am talking about, Delphi technique. So it is a subjective judgmental technique in which a panel of experts are asked a questionnaire. Okay, what it means by questionnaire? So we basically frame a series of questions, we present that to the experts, then based on the answers to that question, okay, we perform the further questionnaire. This is an iterative process. Okay, so what it's saying, it is subjective judgmental technique in which a panel of experts are asked a questionnaire regarding particular issue. Okay, the issue which we want to predict. Okay, on the basis of their response, next questionnaire, okay, see, next questionnaire, basically it's an iterative process, is prepared. Okay, it is iterative method and is long-term method. So if you have ever visited a homeopathy doctor, I do not know if you ever got a chance to visit, let's say, right, then you will note that he will ask you a series of questions, okay, that are not even relevant to your exactly to your illness or whatever. Okay, so homeopathy works like that. It basically works on behavior. They actually try to basically find out that how you respond. Okay, so they will ask you a series of questions like how you are feeling, okay, what makes you angry, whether you feel tired or not. They will frame a series of questionnaire. Then based on the responses that you are giving, they will ask you further questions. Okay, their next questions are always framed based on your responses to the earlier questions. Okay, then finally, based on your answers, they will tell you that this medicine is suitable for your problem. Okay, this is how homeopathy works. However, it has nothing to do with the forecasting. I was just trying to make you understand how this technique works. Okay, so we basically frame a series of questions and then we put it in front of the experts. The experts answers to that questions, and then based on those answers that we are getting, we frame further questions, then again present to experts. Then based on that answers, we frame further questions that keep iterating this process until we came to conclusion that, yeah, this is what I want, or this is the final result that we were expecting. Okay, so this was the Delphi technique. So we'll not go into much details about the other subjective techniques or anything, because objective are more relevant to us, subjective techniques. Okay, so we'll see what are the objective techniques. So first of all, we have time series analysis. Okay, we have this time series analysis. What is time series analysis? See, most of the data that we are going to study, we have time based data. Okay, so let's say I am talking about the sale. Okay, how much sale I have done in the past week, in past month, and the month before that, and again month before that. Basically, let's say I am recording a data for the 5 years. Okay, then I have data of 60 months. I will have 60 points to plot. I will see that what was happened in January 2015, February 2015, March 2015. Then I will record the data for 2016, 2017, 2018, and so on. So this is basically time series, because I am recording the data against the time, and it is very common in actual scenarios. Okay, a lot of time we are recording the data based on the time. Okay, so here what it's saying is past data is available. Okay, this is very important. In subjective methods, no past data was available, but in objective method, past data is available to us. So it's saying past data is available on the basis of which future demand should be forecasted. So this is a very objective method. We will have a table, okay, it may be Excel sheet or any database. You have recorded the values of your past, of their past experiences, okay, how much sale you got in 2015, or even how much sale was there in winter, how much sale was there in summer, you know. And sometimes we say that it's off season, it's on season, we got the sales in off season. How company predicts? Because company predicts that the season will not, that the sale will not be that good in off season. So what they do, they provide you discounts, because they know if we provide to keep the sales at the optimum level, they provide discounts to the consumers, okay, so that their sales should be more. Okay, to match their sale targets, they provide the discounts in the off season period. How they predict that? Because they have the past data. They know that the last year the sale was not proper in, let's say we are talking about summer clothes, okay, as per the Indian weather, obviously you will not have much sales for the summer clothes, you know, in the December month, okay, in November December month, because there are a lot of winters in this time period. Okay, if we're talking about north area, then to increase the sales during this period, what company will do? Company will provide discounts in this period. Okay, how they find out based on the past data, that yeah, in last December, in December 2015, in December 2016, 17, 18, every time the sales in the last period of the every year, the sales are less for the summer clothes. So they decided, the committee decided to provide the discount. Okay, now next, what is saying? Statistical tools such as concept of average, regression analysis, etc., are used depending upon the type of data. Okay, so there are various statistical tools that we use to predict this data. We will see in further classes what are those tools and how to use them. But yet saying that we have various tools to predict the data, various statistical tools. Okay, so this is basically, next what we have is data. Now this is the key part. Okay, you know, this is very important thing, especially these days everybody is talking about data. There is a lot of jobs going on in this field, like data engineer, data analyst, data scientist, then business analytics, and a lot of jobs are going on in this domain. Why? Because we are generating lot of data nowadays. We have all sort of devices, sensors, all sort of online activities that we are currently doing every day, every second, everything is generating data. Okay, so by using that data, you can certainly predict that how this human is going to behave, right? So yeah, we will be seeing very simple things. Okay, that is not much even anywhere near to what actually happens. But yeah, just to give you a flavor. So first of all, data. So we have two types of data. First is constant data. Now constant data means there is no trend in the data. Okay, and the second one is data with the trend. Okay, first one is constant data. See, no trend. And the second one is data with the trend. Okay, so in case of constant data, now constant data doesn't mean that the value will remain same. It just means that the data is revolving around a certain point. Okay, let's say I am collecting the weight of the students in a class. Okay, so obviously the weight, how much weight will be there in the engineering students? They might be from the range of 60 to 80 or 90. Okay, it's not like that every year the weight will keep on increasing, it will go to 110, 120, 130. It doesn't happen like that. Yeah? So there might be an average of around 75 or 80 kgs, right? So the weight will remain, the average weight will remain constant and the fluctuations will be there. So this sort of data, we call it a constant data. Okay, basically there is no trend in the data, so that data we call constant data. And to do the forecasting in such sort of data, we use some sort of methods, which is simple average. We will see what it is. It is a very basic concept. Then we have weighted average, then we have moving average. Okay, Then we have weighted moving average and then exponential smoothing. We will see all of these in further classes, right? We will go through all of these. What is exponential smoothing? What is weighted moving average? What is moving average, weighted average, or simple average? And what, where we, in what condition we choose width method? We will see all that. Okay. Then we have data with the trend. Okay. So yeah, this is the key part basically. So to predict the data with the trend, we use first of all regression analysis. Then we have line of best fit. It is basically a part of regression analysis. Okay. The regression analysis can also be linear or non-linear. Okay. We will mostly be studying about linear only. We will not go much into non-linear analysis. But yeah, regression analysis can be linear or it can be non-linear. Okay. And we obtain the line of best fit to get the trend of the data. Okay. So yeah, from next class, we will start seeing what is simple average, weighted average, moving average. And within 2-3 lectures, I think so. It might take one to more. We will complete this forecasting part. Okay, well, if you have any doubts, you can always ask me in comment section or you can reach me personally. Well, bye bye. We will meet in next class.